Well, not quite the way that I wanted to kick off Friday Night SmackDown tonight, but nonetheless, the very eerie, the very strange, the one and only Boogeyman.
Who cares, Michael? It's a strange night. We got RKO, Vinny visiting us from Raw. We got Shawn Michaels, John Cena. What a hell of a night we have tonight. And let's go ahead and start it off with this freak, the Boogeyman. Finley figured out what I did not figure out, what Booker T, the King, did not figure out, and that was a way to get the Boogeyman.
Yeah, last week, little bastard, Finley's little leprechaun.
Hey, watch your language. He's got parents, okay?
Who lives under
the ring. What are those parents, Mr. and Mrs. Bastard?
Little bastard tried to steal
a leprechaun, Michael.
Tried to steal Boogeyman's worms as this matchup officially gets underway. And off that distraction, Finley used a shillelagh to the back of the knee to pin Boogeyman here last week.
You have a problem with that?
Well, not at all. And you know, set up for a no way out. Boogeyman and Finley one-on-one. Little preview of here tonight on Friday Night SmackDown. And look at Finley hammering away on Boogeyman. And how do you combat Boogeyman?
I never figured it out. I didn't. I was champion longer than anybody in the WWE in SmackDown history, and I never figured it out.
Well, maybe Finley.
King Booker didn't figure it out.
Oh! Maybe Finley has the right recipe, so to speak.
You have Finley in here you think has the edge because of experience, but you have the completely unorthodox Boogeyman. Throw all that out the window.
Finley continues the pressure on the Boogeyman as we kick off what, well, John said earlier on is going to be a strange night, a very special night, a special edition of Friday Night SmackDown, two nights away from perhaps the biggest tag team main event in SmackDown history at No Way Out.
Perhaps, there's no doubt about it, Michael. You got both world champions. You got the tag team champions. All four of them, world champions or previous world champions, going to be in one ring Sunday at the Staples Center at No Way Out.
And Boogeyman trying to get back to his feet. Finley with that knee right to the midsection. It seems to have the puzzle of the Boogeyman solved, at least for the past couple of weeks. Boogey whipped into the corner. There's a big boot to the face of the Fighting Irishman, and Finley follows it up with a clothesline.
Not only that, Michael, if you remember on ECW, Teddy Long invited Bobby Lashley to be here tonight.
Yes, and here, and look at this, kick out by the Boogeyman. Happened this past Tuesday night, ECW on Sci-Fi, and it was Teddy Long, the general manager of SmackDown, who really, well, Lashley thanked Teddy Long for really helping his career here. Remember, Lashley started right here on SmackDown. In fact, won his first championship from you right here on SmackDown, the United States title.
I don't think that's important you bring that up.
Oh, and Finley sent through the second rope to the floor below. And look at the look on the face of this really weird dude, the Boogeyman.
Weird dude? That's how you characterize a guy with red paint all over his face has worms in his pocket.
How the hell would you characterize him?
A nut. He's a freaking lunatic.
Oh, an inverted atomic drop. Boogeyman thrust to the throat of Finley. Very unorthodox style, to say the least. All these gyrations Boogeyman goes through in the ring. Nobody home. Finley steps out of the way. Went for the clothesline and just caught Boogeyman in the back of the head.
Michael, it tells you something about SmackDown when you have all three promotions, their biggest stars.
Here's the cover and a kick out.
All wanting to be here. I've driven the rating so high, Michael, everybody wants to hop on my bandwagon.
You?
Yes.
And look at this, Finley. Unorthodox style as well. Next, you're going to start thanking people I guess you're going to start taking credit for selling out the Staples Center for No Way Out Sunday night in Los Angeles.
I sold it out with Eddie Guerrero. I sold it out at WrestleMania. Now I've sold it out as an announcer. Hell yeah, I'll take credit.
Finley trying to take that protective covering off that steel turnbuckle. And as the referee goes back to the turnbuckle, Finley grabs the shillelagh. And look at little bastard.
He's a leprechaun. Here he comes.
With a second shillelagh in hand. And the little bastard going out for the boogeyman. Hey,
what
wait a minute.
People are over the ring.
Little boogeyman.
Finley looks like Gulliver.
Finley looks like he's seen a ghost, and so is little bastard. And there's boogeyman with that staff to the gut. Here's the cover. And boogeyman pulls one out of Finley's payback tonight for the boogeyman.
The boogeyman.
I'm seeing double.
You're seeing one and a half.
What the hell just happened?
Little bastard
told me this didn't just happen. Somebody make some sense of this, please. This is the damnedest thing I've ever seen in my... Oh, my God.
And he swerves, too.
No, come on.
He swerves, too. Little boogeyman.
Little boogeyman? What the hell are you talking about, little boogeyman?
Well, how would you describe the guy? We got to see this to get to believe it. And I don't even know if this replay is going to do it justice.
What in the
Look
hell?
At the face of little bastard.
He's not a little bastard.
Meantime, a little bit of a payback for last week. Referee never saw it. Referee Chris Kay is shocked as all. As everybody else, and Boogeyman picks up the victory here tonight.
What the hell was that?
Well, ladies and gentlemen,